Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss the introductory part of digital communication. So we'll discuss why we are studying digital communication at all. I suppose all of you have already studied analog communication. So we'll see the advantages of digital communication and then we'll see its disadvantages also. So then after that, we'll discuss the advantages with disadvantages and then we'll relate them. And then we'll see how advantages are overpowering the disadvantages and we are getting the digital communication as the future of analog communication. So now after that, we'll discuss the block diagram of digital communication. So first we'll begin with the block diagram and then we'll see advantages and disadvantages. So this is the block diagram of the transmitter of digital communication. So in transmitting part, we have the message signal. So the message signal can be analog message signal like the voice. Voice is analog message signal, or it can be a digital message signal or discrete message signal. So like pictures, picture is a discrete message signal. So if I have black and white picture, then it is digital. Digital is, it is because it is comprised of two levels only, but if I don't have black and white, then it is discrete. So now I have message signal which is analog or discrete or digital. Now information source. This message signal which we are getting is in the physical form. So if you have to communicate with any transmitter, you'll send the signal in the physical form. So voice is the vibrations in the air. So it is a physical signal. So it has to convert into electrical signal to go to the electronic part of the transmitter. So the vibrations are converted into the electrical signal using a part in the information source, which is called the transducer. Now the transducer is only converting the physical signal into the electrical signal. Now it is not converting the digital to analog or analog to digital. So it is making the signal to remain in as it is format. Now, so here also I'll get analog or digital both. So after that I have source encoder. Source encoder is used to remove the redundancy in the code. So, source encoder is removing the redundancy, which in turn will help me to reduce the bandwidth. So, if some part of signal is removed, so bandwidth requirement would be less because now I have less signal to transmit, so bandwidth requirement would be less. And with the help of source encoding, we can do compression of the signal as well. So data compression is also there. So Huffman coding, Shannon Fano coding, etc. are used for data compression. So after all this, the signal is now converted into digital signal. So now my digital signal goes to the channel encoder. Channel encoder is used to add redundancy. Now I hope you are now shocked that here I am reducing redundancy. Now here myself I am adding redundancy. So let's see why. So I am adding redundancy to make my signal capable of detecting error and correcting it. So if I have to detect error and correct error, I'll add some redundancy bits which will be detected at the receiver, and receiver in accordance to those redundancy bits will detect that if error is present in the bit or not, and if it is present, it will correct it also. So let's suppose if I have a code 0110. So now here I have two ones, which means I have even number of ones. So if I have to send this signal, I'll add some signal. So if I add 01 before it, so which means now I have three ones. So this signal is sent to the receiver, and at the receiver, if this signal is changed, so if an error occurs and now I received 0111. So now this 01 indicates that there should be an odd number, but now I have even number of ones. I have four ones, which is even, but here I had three ones, which was odd. So now that this thing changed, so I can say that some error has occurred and some bit has changed from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, because of which the parity is changed from odd to even. So now this is the thing which is used in this channel encoder block. So I hope now you understand why I am adding redundancy. So I am adding redundancy to detect and correct errors. So we have adaptive delta modulation and pulse code modulation for this. So now modulator is used such that the carrier signal is superimposed with the message signal. So carrier is high power signal, message is low power signal. So if I have to send message, it will not go up to a long distance. So if I have to send the message to a longer distance, I'll use some high power signal on which the message will superimpose and it will go to a longer distance. So this process is happening here. Same like analog communication, in which we studied angle modulation and amplitude modulation. So similarly, we have here also angle modulation and amplitude modulation. So some other advantages of using modulations are also there. Like modulation is required for multiplexing of signals. So we can have different carriers. So at different carriers, we can impose different signals and we can send it to the same channel. So if I am sending two signals in space and these two are at different frequency of carrier. So if I am sending one signal here and another signal also here with the different frequency of carrier, so they won't be getting mixed. So if I am sending same message signal in the same direction without any carrier, they'll get mixed. But with the help of different frequency carriers, they won't get mixed. This is called multiplexing. So multiplexing can be achieved using carriers. So after that, we can also use the carriers to transmit the signal up to a longer distance. Antenna height is also reduced. The bandwidth is also reduced. Plus there are a lot of other advantages as well. So now modulator is so we have ASK, FSK, PSK, QPSK. We'll study about all of these in the next sessions. So after that, we have antenna, which is taking this signal and it is converting this signal into the form of EM waves. So EM waves are going to the channel, and channel could be anything. It could be any coaxial cable, it could be space surrounding you, it could be water as well. So EM waves are going through the channel and it is received at the receiver. So now I'll make the block diagram of the receiver. So now we were at the antenna. So EM waves comes to the antenna, and antenna now converts these EM waves into electrical signal. So now after that, we have demodulator. Demodulator is the inverse of modulator, which means we are now separating carrier from the message. So we are extracting message from the carrier now. So after that we have channel decoder. Channel encoder was adding the redundancy to check and correct errors. So now here at the channel decoder we are checking that any error was there, and if the error is there, it will correct it. Check and correction of error. So now how it will check the and correct the error? It will check and correct the error with the help of the redundancy which was added here. So with the help of redundant bit, it will check the error and then it will correct it. After that we have source decoder. Source decoder is converting this digital signal. So up till here we have a digital signal. So here it will convert this digital signal into analog counterpart. After that we have output transducer. Output transducer is converting this electrical signal. So now we have analog or digital. The analog or digital signal is converted into the physical signal. So this is electrical signal. Electrical signal is now again converted to physical signal with the help of transducer. So now when I convert the electrical signal into physical signal, I'll receive the message which was sent by the sender. So I hope now you understand, if a sender is sending the message, how it is going from these many blocks and coming to the receiver. So it is crossing a long path and then only it is coming to the receiver. So now we'll see what are the advantages of digital communication system. So the first and the foremost advantage of digital communication is for internet transmission. So internet we can access through digital communication. So I hope you know that 4G is also working on the digital communication and we are widely using 4G. Now we are talking about 5G. So digital communication is the soul of this. So for internet and 4G we require digital communication. So you all have phones, laptop, desktops right now. So all of them are having processors and processors are working on digital data. So we have advanced processors which are working only on digital data, and we are unable to design the inside of processor in most of the countries. In only few countries the processors are designed. So architecture we don't know. So we are just knowing about the other parts, which are other peripherals which are connected to the processor. So to operate a processor we require the digital data. So next is storage. Storage of digital data is rather very easy and accessible. So like we have various storage devices which are very very cheap. So we can easily store the digital data. After that, I already told you in digital data we have error detection and error correction capability. We can detect and correct error. After that, we can encrypt the data. Encryption means I can send the encrypted data, the data can be changed, and I can send the changed data, and only the person who is having the key. So it is like a lock. So only the person who is having the right key will access the data. So I can easily block my data from the unwanted users. After that, I can easily multiplex the data using TDMA and CDMA. After that, I can compress the data. So we can compress the data and we can send the data in the compressed format as well. So which is reducing the bandwidth requirement also. So after that, we can use various repeaters. The use of repeaters is very easy. So repeaters are the receiver and the transmitter. So when my signal is traveling, it becomes fade in the channel. So I'll again use a repeater, which is receiver. So here I'll have a receiving station, will receive this signal, amplify it and transmit the amplified signal again. So now I hope you understand what is the repeater. After that, I have flexible bandwidth implementation. And due to the large scale production, it is inexpensive also. After that, we have flexible hardware implementation. And due to mass production and like high requirements, it is inexpensive. Now we'll see various disadvantages of digital communication system. We saw very large number of blocks, so we can see that it is the circuit which is really complex. So the first disadvantage is that it is having a complex circuit. After that, so the spectrum of frequencies required for the transmission of this signal is very large, which means it requires large bandwidth. After that, it is requiring large power. So large power consumption is there because we have a large number of blocks and each block requires some power to operate. So it has large power consumption. After that, so synchronization is essential for this type of communication. We require synchronization between transmitter and receiver, only then we can detect the signal correctly. And at last we have, because in analog, like let's take an example of a signal which is changing from 1 to 0. So if I have this signal, I can have infinite number of levels between 0 and 1. But in digital, this signal is represented by either 0 or 1. So this is less accurate. I hope now you understand why we are requiring digital communication. We have various advantages which are overpowering the small disadvantages. And with various modification in the design of various blocks in digital communication, we can easily tackle these disadvantages. I'll stop at this point. I hope you like this video. Like this video, subscribe the channel and stay tuned for the further videos. Thank you.